fixing to have a fireworks show. This is the kind of stuff they still do in little towns, see? American flag, fire trucks. Nobody burning anything down. Nobody rioting. Kids playing. No COVID cases. Come on.
I walked through a county courthouse square. On a park bench, an old man was sitting there. I said, "Your old courthouse is kind of run down." He said, "No, it'll do for our little town." I said, "Your old flagpole has leaned a little bit, and that's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it." He said, "Have a seat." And I sat down. "Is this the first time you've been to our little town?" I said, "I think it is." He said, "I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a little hole in that flag there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key sat watching it write and say, 'Can you see?' And it got a bad rip in New Orleans with Pakenham and Jackson tugging at its seams. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag, but she waved on, though. She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville, and she got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp and low a time or two. She was in Korea, Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now they've about quit waving back here at home. In her own good land here, she's been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, and refused. And the government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. And she's getting threadbare and she's wearing thin, but she's in good shape for the shape she's in. Cause she's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, we take her down every night, we don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her upright. On second thought, I do like to brag, cause I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag.
Okay, guys, good evening. I am glad you are here, and amen to our Lord and Savior for giving us this window. From the beginning of this morning, when it looked like it was literally going to rain every hour, we were praying that God would give us an opportunity to come together in fellowship. This is our church tonight. We are here celebrating our Lord and Savior for giving us this opportunity to live in a free country, but also have the church, His bride, as the blessing of this country that we have here. And we are thankful for all of the men, the women who made this possible tonight. We had tons of people from our church under Stoney DeVille who spent so much time making sure all of this was able to happen. So we're very thankful for our team from Eastview. If you are a visitor, I am Pastor Hunter Jones, the pastor of Eastview. We want to welcome you. This is our fifth year doing this in the community, and not only are we thankful that we were able to do this, we're thankful that you are here. If you do not belong to a church, we want to take this opportunity not just to pour into you this moment of encouragement in the midst of a very chaotic time, but we want to take this moment to invite you to church. This Sunday at 10 o'clock will be our first Sunday inside the church. We've been outside worshiping. God's been very good to our church outside, but we're going to be starting this week inside the sanctuary at 10 a.m. If you are not a part of a church, we really, really pray that we get to see you, build relationships, and get to fellowship this coming Sunday. So before we go into fireworks, we're going to have a moment of prayer, and then Marty Higginbotham is going to sing the national anthem. So we're going to start with a moment of one of our men who love the Lord, but he also loves his country and served his country. Currently on duty, Jacob Partridge, he's going to pray for us, and then we're going to turn it over to Marty Higginbotham.
If you would, pray with me. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you so thankful for this country that you've blessed so richly. Thank you, God, for the part in the rain to allow us to put this show on. God, I ask that you keep us safe during this fireworks show and help it to be beautiful and meaningful to everyone here. And please fill everyone with your Holy Spirit as we leave this place. And God, I ask that you be with this country, especially right now during this time of virus and turmoil. Please, God, help us to be united under you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
One thing I want to say before Marty sings for us. Marty Higginbotham right now is serving our community as a probation officer. He's a veteran, U.S. Army veteran. The last time he sang this national anthem, he was actually serving our country in Germany. We are thankful that we have a man at our church that loves the Lord, that serves his country, and here serving you guys tonight. So round of applause, all of us, for Marty as he sings our national anthem. And then we are going to go into our fireworks show.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
Oh, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, there ain't no doubt.